Hey guys, it's Kim Dao here, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to be opening up two fuku bukuros that I got in Shibuya 109 this morning. If you guys didn't know, a fuku bukuro is a lucky bag where stores would generally try and get rid of all of their stock from last year. Now, the cool thing about it is that you don't know what you get inside the bag. A few days ago, I uploaded my first fuku bukuro video, so if you guys haven't yet, you can watch that video, I'll link that down below. Just before I start this video, if you guys haven't yet, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. I have a lot of Japan content coming this year, and also subscribe to my vlog channel as well because I'm uploading more fuku bukuro videos on there. And if you guys want to see the vlogs where I actually went shopping to buy them, then make sure you guys check out my link down below. Alright, let's start the video. The first bag I'm going to be opening up is a Cecile McVie bag. Now, I've been buying this bag for the past couple of years. This bag was 10,800 yen with tax, so that's around $100 US. It comes with a coat, and you can choose which coat you get in the bag, which I think is kind of cool because usually the coat is, I guess, the most expensive item, so you want to make sure that you get the one that you want. But that's the only item that I know is in this bag. Everything else I don't know. So let's open this bag up and see what we've got. The first item is the puffy jacket. I love this. Just a very simple black jacket. The fur part I don't really like, but you can take it off, which is good. I mean, it's not too thick, but I think it would be perfect for the springtime or like some of the warmer winter days. Originally, this price was 12,800 yen, so that's about $128, which is less than what I paid for this bag. I have a few jackets from Cecile McVie, and I really like them. I've kept them for years because they're really good quality. Next. Oh, is this a blanket? 2 years ago in the Cecile McVie fuku bukuro, I received exactly the same blanket, but it was a pink color. So I guess they do recycle a lot of their stuff. Though it is very soft material and it is comfortable because I used the pink one for quite a while. Because I already have one exactly the same as this, I don't think I would keep it. I'm probably gonna give it away. Next. Ooh, oh no, it's a dress. Oh, that's cool, I like that. It looks like a trench coat, but it's got some lace detailing on it and has no sleeves. This is so pretty. I love that. Can definitely see myself wearing that. This dress was originally 6,900 yen, which sounds about right because whenever you see something like this in Japan, it's usually around that price range. Next, I got this pink jacket and it's so cute, guys. It's very thin though. The original price was 3,900 yen, so about $39 for this. Next, we have a hoodie. And what does it say? Hopefully it makes sense. It says... I can already tell it doesn't make sense. Conceit is much fun. Life is only once. Conceit is much fun. Life is only once. But anyway, how much is this jacket? Holy crap, this hoodie is originally 4,900 yen, which is $49. I mean, the quality is nice, the material is soft. Next. Oh, next is this sweater. Oh, it's a sweater dress. I love sweater dresses. They're so comfortable to wear, very quick and easy to put on. I usually wear these when I'm in a rush because you can just chuck it on and walk out of the house. The original price for this was 5,900 yen, so $59. Ooh, pair of jeans. Actually, I remembered in the Cecile McVie fuku bukuro 2 years ago, I got a pair of jeans as well. This is the pair of jeans, and okay, it's not really my style because I prefer skinny jeans. These are a bit more bigger. This is a size M, so okay, pretty much all of the lucky bags are one size unless they say so. So one size in Japan usually means between a size small to a size medium. It's 5,900 yen, so that's $59. Though I gotta be honest, the quality of the jeans, I don't think it's that great. This is the last item. Oh, I love this color. It's a sweater in lilac. Don't have a lilac colored sweater yet. I love that. Okay, very nice quality. It's quite thin, but It is very soft and comfortable. The original price was 4,900 yen, so $49 for it. That is everything inside the Cecile McBee bag. I'm actually really impressed. I liked everything except for that weird hoodie and the jeans. I like this bag, so I would give this one like an 8 out of 10 actually. I'm gonna buy this again next year. Next bag I'm going to open up is the Min Plume bag. This is my first time buying a Min Plume bag, so I'm a little bit nervous. They tape up the bag. Hey! Oh my god. Sorry, I sneezed really loud. This bag is actually cheaper than the other ones I got. This one was 5,400 yen. That is around $54. The store said that the bag's value is around 30,000 to 40,000 yen, which is around $300 to $400. There are 15 items inside this bag. I think it's like 10 clothing items and 5 accessories. Ooh. Oh. Okay, there's a lot of stuff inside. Let's start off with this. A bunch of accessories. Oh, belts! Ah! I got a bunch of different belts. So, this rose one, two bows in black and red. The price of the belts alone are 1,500 yen each. Next is this leopard print short sleeve sweater. Actually, I can wear this with a skirt. If I have a black skirt, that will look really cute. The material is actually quite thick and feels very soft. The original price for this one is 2,300 yen, so about $23. Oh, more accessories. Necklace with some pearls on it and some bows. The original price for this one is 1,900 yen, so that's $19 for this. Then I got this pink hair tie with this love heart charm on it. The original price for this one is 430 yen. I think this is like a bow necklace. Yeah. Oh, that's pretty. And then I got this little sheep bag. I don't think I would use this. The original price for this bag is 3,200 yen. That's $32 for this. Okay, I don't think it's worth $32. I'd say it's worth like $5. Ooh. I got this off-the-shoulder dress and okay, it looks very pretty. But the thing is that it's very see-through, so you have to wear something inside. Though it is very stretchy, so I would say it would fit up to like a size large. So the original price for this one is 5,900 yen, $59. I just want to tell you that just take the prices with a grain of salt, because most likely what they do is that they up the price to make you feel like that you are getting more money's worth. In reality, like, I think this is something that you can find on Wish. Oh, it's a bag. I got this holographic see-through bag, and this was really trending this year. And inside you have a little pouch. This bag is originally 3,900 yen, which, okay, that sounds outrageous because I think it's only worth about $10 for it. But you know what? It's cute. Yeah. Oh, I kind of like this. It's kind of like a bomber jacket. Feathers, so it's very soft. But I can imagine myself wearing this and all this stuff coming off and going everywhere, because already it's falling off. The original price is 4,300 yen, so $43 for this.
It's like Benito flakes.
Oh, it looks like Benito flakes. It does. Just a very simple, plain, sleeveless shirt. And this one was originally... Come on, I think they're just like pulling my leg here. It's originally 4,300 yen for a plain shirt. Really? Come on. Honestly, if I'm paying like $43 for a t-shirt like this, it better be like Gucci. This is a bit outrageous, but it's a very simple top that is nice, and luckily I did not pay $43 for it. It's a skirt, so it's a skirt, but there's shorts inside. And it also comes with a belt as well. Feels really good quality. I like it. It's very thick, so it's good to wear during the winter. It is quite small, but it is quite stretchy at the back. So I would think it would fit up to a size medium. Top. I don't know if I would wear this, just because I think it's going to fall apart. The original price is 1,900 yen, so $19. It could work. Got this blue checkered top. I don't really wear stuff like this, but I know a lot of people that would wear it. This one was originally 2,900 yen, so $29. These guys are overpricing everything. Like, this is not worth that. It would be worth like $5. It's like a raincoat. I'm scared to put it on, because what if like it's saying something really bad? Oh, honestly, it's not something I would wear.
French.
It's French, okay.
Everything will be alright.
Okay. Oh, that's okay. That sounds okay. The hood is a bit strange because it's like a totally different material. It's a dress. Oh, it looks like a sailor uniform dress. I was going to say maybe in my early 20s, but even then, I don't think I would wear this. It's just a bit too childish for me. The original price for this one is 4,900 yen, $49. Shorts, I would definitely wear this because you can wear this underneath. I actually have a lot of these because a lot of my dresses are quite short. I'm a short person, I'm only 155 centimeters. So if I wear a long dress, usually it makes me look shorter, so I prefer wearing shorter dresses. And because of that, I like to wear shorts underneath just to be safe in case my dress flies up. A long white skirt. Feels decent quality, it's not the best, but yeah, it's still pretty good, I'd wear it. The original price is 4,300 yen for it, so $43. Last item in the bag is this checkered, what is it? Checkered dress. Can't tie it around your waist. Yeah, it's cute though, I like this. The original price for this one is 2,900 yen, so $29. That is all the stuff in the Min Plume bag. So okay, overall, I think it's 50-50. I like half of the stuff in there, but it is a lucky bag and you can't expect to like everything in it. So usually for the things I don't like, I give it away to friends or I just donate them to charity. Overall, I'll give this bag a 6 out of 10 because it was cheaper than all the other bags and I got a lot of stuff in there. Will I buy this bag again? To be honest, yeah, because it is cheaper than all the other bags. That is it for today's video. Thank you so much guys for watching and make sure you guys thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. Follow me on my vlog channel because I've been uploading lots of Japan vlogs. You can also watch the vlogs where I went out to shop for these bags. Follow me on all my social media, that's all linked down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!